God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O God, the Holy Ghost, Sanctifier of the faithful,
have mercy upon us.
O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God,
have mercy upon us.
Remember not, for Christ, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forefathers, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare thy people, whom thou hast redeemed with thy most precious blood, and by thy mercy preserve us forever.
Spare us, good Lord,
from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the crafts and assaults of the devil, and from everlasting damnation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all blindness of heart, from pride, vainglory, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all want of charity.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all inordinate and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart, and contempt of thy word and commandment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By the mystery of thy holy incarnation, by thy holy nativity and submission to the law, by thy baptism, fasting, and temptation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By thy agony and bloody sweat, by thy cross and passion, by thy precious death and burial, by thy glorious resurrection and ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Ghost.
Good Lord, deliver us.
In all time of our tribulation, in all time of our prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
We sinners do beseech thee to hear us, O Lord God, and that it may please thee to rule and govern thy holy church universal in the right way.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of thy word, and that both by their preaching and living they may set it forth and show it accordingly.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to bless and keep all thy people.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to send forth laborers into thy harvest, and to draw all mankind into thy kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give to all people increase of grace, to hear and receive thy word, and to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to bring into the way of truth all such as have erred and are deceived.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give us a heart to love and fear thee, and diligently to live after thy commandments.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
And it may please thee so to rule the hearts of thy servants, the President of the United States, and all others in authority, that they may do justice, and love mercy, and walk in the ways of truth.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to make wars to cease in all the world, to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, and to bestow freedom upon all peoples.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to show thy pity upon all prisoners and captives, the homeless and the hungry, and all who are desolate and oppressed.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to give and preserve to our use the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that in due time all may enjoy them.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to inspire us in our several callings to do the work which thou givest us to do with singleness of heart as thy servants and for the common good.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord.
That it may please thee to preserve all who are in danger by reason broken or torn by strife.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to visit the lonely, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, and to comfort with thy presence those who are failing and infirm.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to support, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to have mercy upon all mankind.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, negligences, and ignorances, and to endue us with the grace of thy Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to thy holy word.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to strengthen such as who stand, to comfort and help the weak-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant that, in the fellowship of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all the saints, we may attain to thy heavenly kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, find thee, mighty to save, through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After the waters of the flood had subsided, God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "Behold, I establish my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the cattle, and every beast of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." And God said, "This is the sign of the covenant which I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you, for all future generations. I set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth, and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant, which is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will look upon it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is upon the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant which I have established between me and all flesh that is upon the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
from the first epistle of Blessed Peter. Christ also died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the Spirit, in which he went and preached to the spirits in prison, who formerly did not obey when God's patience waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, 8 persons were saved through water. Baptism, which corresponds to this, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a clear conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
May we, in the word written and in the word spoken, encounter the very word incarnate.
Amen.
One of the perhaps, well, not most used images in classical and Renaissance art, but certainly one that has gotten a lot of attention, is today's reading from the Gospel, the temptation of Jesus. This is Mark's version of it, which is really only two verses inside the broader summary of the entirety of Jesus' life and ministry until his passion. And we always hear this story on the first Sunday in Lent to help us focus on our own trials and temptations. And there are so many of those images, and you can Google them if you want. There's Jesus alone in the wilderness, which is striking in and of itself. There are lots of Jesus casting the devil down the hill, and the devil or demons. The image we use for today's Mass is multiple demons tormenting Jesus, or trying to torment Jesus. Many of Jesus just with Satan himself. There's a striking contemporary one where Jesus is sitting on the rock and his head is down, and there's a person sitting next to him just talking to him, and you can tell what's going on there. My current favorite, though, is Jesus sitting in a lovely garden. This is a medieval image. He's sitting on a bench, looking at a kind-hearted monk sort of dude with horns and a beard. And the monk dude, who is clearly Satan, is holding a loaf of bread out to Jesus. Jesus is rather serenely sitting on the bench, basically going, "Not today, Satan," with his hand. You can look this up. It's really there. And it's all really quite calm. Here's another vision, though. This one in words. It's the poem Jesus' Angels, a poem in prose by Carol Penner. It was a miracle, really, that we were there at all. We sold our trade goods remarkably quickly and set off for home far earlier than expected. The long trek through the wilderness went so fast, it was midday when we came to the spring where we always stop. Having gained so much time, we decided to spend the night. My son Cornelius took the notion of climbing the high mountain. "I came to see the world, Father," he said to me. It's our last trip before he becomes a centurion. He'll see the world soon enough. I sent two servants with him. There are lions in these parts. And the rest of us settled in for a long nap in the shade. Hours later, I heard his voice echoing over the rocks. And you could hear Cornelius saying, "Father, we found a man, and he was up there all by himself, and he could barely talk or anything, and we brought him down." Cornelius poured out his story, how they'd reached the top only to find the man sitting there. He says his name is Jesus, And can you believe it, Father? He called us angels. I don't know what that man was doing on that mountain, other than perishing from hunger. I do know that he was as close to death as you can get, and there was no way he could have come down himself. We saved him, and that's a fact. He was weak as a lamb. We fed him bread and wine. We carried him on our camels as far as Capernaum. I have a friend there who runs an inn, so we left Jesus there to gather his strength. I'll settle the bill next time I'm through. He made quite an impression on my son Cornelius. They were always talking late into the night. When we left Jesus at the inn, he grasped my hand. How can I repay you for this kindness? I told him he owed me nothing. And then he said, I will always remember the mercy you have shown me. As we left the city, I laughed with my companions about it. So somewhere in Galilee, there's a poor man who remembers me. Everyone should be so lucky. My friends, Lent is not just solely about our own sins and temptations to sin, although it is certainly that. It's also about supporting others in their trials and temptations, and performing works of mercy to practice our membership in the body of Christ. In this Lenten season, who can you be an angel to? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling as you are able. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord
acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most fiercely have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our sins. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the midst of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who hast promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. This is a true saying and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. If anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the perfect offering for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. My friends in Christ, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Faithfulness and truth shall be the shield and guard.
acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice at our hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both for our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Throughout all ages, world without end. Now offer unto thee the memorial. memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, render unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the Savior. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseech thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we, and all thy little church, may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we, and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion, may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught, Grant, Almighty God, that your people may recognize their weakness and put their whole trust in your strength, so that they may rejoice forever in the protection of your loving providence. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Check their Facebook page, or you may call their number directly to get any schedule updates as they may happen. We hope to reopen as soon as we can, most obviously. This Thursday, we will celebrate the feast of St. Matthias with said Mass at 7:30, so please do join us for that. And of course, particularly in this time of Lent, I invite and encourage and ask you for your contributions and pledges both here and perhaps to others for whom you can be an angel. Mr. Munoz, what else? Let us conclude with the Angelus. The angel of the Lord announced unto Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
Be unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace,
Virgin Mary, may by his cross and passion be brought unto the glory of his resurrection, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, now and forever.
Amen.